Good morning and welcome to America's Home Cooking. We are in 90 degree weather. And what I did was, I'm making herbal teas for my family. This one has papaya, orange, red clover, raspberry leaves, mauve bark, sorrel, and some senna. Ah, that was not supposed to go in there. Okay. What I'm going to do is let this sit. And the reason I'm making it is because we were in 90 degree weather and then we dropped into the 80s during the day. But the night temperatures are 60, so it's quite cool. And I want to make sure we don't come down with a cold or anything, so I'm already preparing to make sure that we don't, because I woke up and I could feel a cold starting to come on, and I said, oh no. We'll sit till tomorrow and then we'll start having this tea to help us. And another thing that I'm doing is I am going to make some trail mix. I have a lot of dried fruit, and this is papaya that I'm cutting up, and I'm going to make some big half gallon jars. So I'm going to have a big bowl of this and I'm going to store it. So if we get hungry, something to munch, and it's nutritious as well. I know you can buy it in the store, but I like making my own combinations, you know. I'll always have papaya and mango in it because that really sets it, but everything else is just like freedom to do what I want. And I'll probably, also knowing me, I will put crystallized ginger in it, which is good. And I'll be putting raisins and nuts in it with a whole lot of other fruit that I have over here. So I'm going to make a big batch of this. So let me get my papaya cut and I'll tell you when I put in the mixed ingredient. Now that I put the papaya in, now I'm doing banana chips. So you can actually see which one that I put in. So let me get these cut up and I'll be back. I'm going to be putting mango into it. I'd like to tell you how much, but the thing is that this is pretty much to your taste. And that's why it's difficult for me to tell you how much I'm putting in. Because you can put any combination you wish in. But I do know I always make sure I have mangoes and papayas. It's my starting base. So I'll keep on cooking until you want to get to the next fruit. Okay, the next thing I'm going to put in is some apples that I sprinkled with apple pie spice. And these were green apples, so there'll be a sweet tartness I'm adding to it now. Yeah, some of these you have to cut, and then other ones you just tear up and it's fine. Another one snap. It'll give a nice smell to it while I get it going. We're going to be adding pears next. You can smell all the smells of the dried fruit coming through. Let me finish tearing this up and I'll be back. The next one we're putting in is pineapple. So let me finish tearing these up and I'll be back. Okay, now I'm going to put some unsweetened coconut in here. I can't tell you how much. You just sort of mix it up. Let me go into your eyes. We're going to be chopping some dried fruit up soon. You're also going to put in dried cranberries as well. They go very good in this. I have to get another bag out though. so the color, you know, matches to your eye what you like or don't like, but this is how I'm making it. So there's no real amount that you put on other than what your family likes. And a lot of this fruit I dried myself. Just slicing these. As you can see, there's a lot that goes into these. They make so much and they're great as a snack. You know, if you want to send your children out with something. I mean, my family, as old as we are, we could sit and demolish this, but it's filling, it's healthy, and you control the amount of sugar that they get. Once again, which is very, very important. Yes, they're getting sugar, but at least you're controlling it. Let me finish cutting these. I need to add the dates. And chop of apricots if you wish to put apricots in this as well, which I have done, but you haven't seen me do it. I do these things. Okay. Now I have to go get my crystallized ginger. Okay. Now the crystallized ginger, you're just going to make slices. It has a good flavor, but you don't want it so strong in big chunks like this that people can't handle. Some people can't handle it. So if you want to make a really big batch and store it, you can do this. I've done it. It doesn't last long in my house, that's the only problem, because we like it. want to know where I bought this. I bought a pound of it on Amazon, crystallized ginger. So if you're looking for it in a large amount so you can do this, that's where I went to Amazon, because it's difficult to find in store. And when you do get it in store, it's such a little amount. And when you want to use it like this, it's very difficult. Other things. We're going to be adding raisins. The box says golden raisins, but as you can see, they're not very golden. That's what happens to my eight box as well. In here. The only thing is that if they're big pieces, you might want to break them in half. The reason I'm not chopping them is if I chop them, I'll get them too small, so I'll just break them up. And you can see this is making a good amount. This is a nice amount. I usually make more than this, but I ran out of some of my dried fruit, which means I'll be having to dehydrate some more. I guess you could put seeds in this as well if you wish. I mean, I have seeds. I could put seeds in here. I could add some sesame seeds, which I might as well. Make this very, very healthy. I also like to buy nuts up, and what I do is I make a mixed nuts. I make sure they don't have salt on them. I add my own salt so I can control the salt, because I just think too many things have too much salt in it. Everybody's got high blood pressure. You know, it's a common thing. Oh, I'm taking this medicine. Please. And if you don't want to add salt to it, you don't have. So I'll be buying mixtures of nuts in my combination that I like, and I will just add them and make a mixed nuts for my family. That is going very well.
I think I'll put some apricots in it too.
See, my apricots went dark.
All because I took them out.
I opened the container and that was it. There's no reason. They smell like apricots and taste like apricots. They just have a funny color to them. Let me cut these up and we'll see how this is going. Okay, we got the apricots in, and here's the trail mix. It's just a lot of chopping on everything. You could pack them in pint jars, quart jars, or half gallons. I should do it in the quarts, but I'm going to do it in the half gallons. Where did I put it? I'm looking for my funnel. Ooh. Oh, here it is. So you can pack, you know, and pack these up for autumn if you wish. And it'd be a nice snack during the holidays anyway. That's how I make some herbal teas and a trail mix. Take care. Bye-bye.